What's going on, everybody? Our Kendry here. Today, I want to talk about Skull and Bones, a game of Ubisoft that has been shown off at a bit of AE3 for the last couple of years, but we haven't actually got our hands on the game itself. We haven't really seen too much of Skull and Bones, more so just small little, you know, videos of gameplay and the idea of what Skull and Bones is. But if you don't know what Skull and Bones is, it's basically For Honor and Sea of Thieves had a baby. You know, players create their own pirate captain, take control of their own customizable ship, and with four other friends, they have 5v5 battles on open water. And yes, there will be a single player campaign. If you're curious whether or not it's going to be a multiplayer only game or have a campaign, I'd imagine it's probably going to play similar to that of For Honor's campaign. But I will hope that it'll actually be like some well thought out, drawn out, lengthy. I'm not saying it has to be like Assassin's Creed long campaign, but it's something that'll be good to play and experience for a good chunk of your time if you don't want to spend your time playing multiplayer so much. Anyways, there's a good amount of hype around the game, but people are lowering their expectations because it's a Ubisoft game, and though Ubisoft isn't as bad as EA or Activision, they do have a habit of making their games look way better than they actually are when they come out. You know, see Watch Dogs and Division. You know, the game is expected to release this year. It's a naval warfare tactical action game, which continues Ubisoft's trend of making a tactical multiplayer game when it comes to their multiplayer franchise. You have Rainbow Six Siege being a tactical shooter, you have For Honor being a tactical fighting game, and Skull and Bones being a tactical action game. So even though we haven't actually gotten our hands on Skull and Bones yet and have only seen Ubisoft release videos, I do think we can get a good, you know, gauge on how the game will play and what it will be like by playing Assassin's Creed. In Assassin's Creed 3, Black Flag, and Odyssey, I don't remember if Origins had naval warfare, but those three games had naval battles, and with Black Flag and Odyssey, naval warfare is a huge part of those two games. It's the main combat in those two games, depending on how you're playing Odyssey. There's a lot of conflict on land, but there's also a lot of conflict on sea. The Black Flag, you're playing a pirate, so obviously you're going to be doing a lot of naval battles. So those two games, more so than three, give you a good, you know, look on what Skull and Bones could potentially be like. Now, these are Ubisoft games, and Ubisoft likes to share the resources between their developers. No, not only that, but Watch Dogs, Assassin's Creed, and For Honor, and like Skull and Bones, all take place in the same universe. Similar to that, Ghost Recon, Siege, Ghost Recon, Rainbow Six, and Splinter Cell all are in the same universe. This isn't speculation or theory, but confirmed by Ubisoft that these games all happen in the exact same universe. So, anyways, getting back on to talking about naval warfare and Assassin's Creed, if you play Odyssey and Black Flag, I think what you experience in those games is the earliest form of what Skull and Bones will be like. It's because of that, I think we are in for a very good game. I do not think this will be another Sea of Thieves where it comes out and it's just an empty mess that's not fun to play, repetitive, and empty. I think it will be literally the naval battles from Assassin's Creed games, but into its own game. Which is good. You know, naval battles in Assassin's Creed are fun. They are amazing. Every battle is fun. It doesn't get old. You know, you fix up and customize your own ship. You pick your crew. Even Odyssey, you can have Bayek, Aya, and Aya from Origins as your ship lieutenants. As well, you can have Evie Fry from Syndicate as a lieutenant on your ship. So, it's pretty cool. It's pretty fun in those two games. I'd imagine Skull and Bones and then customization and outfitting your crew will be even more expansive in terms of customization than, say, Odyssey. Because Odyssey, you know, even though you can't customize your ship, it's more just to improve it. The main focus of Skull and Bones is your ship and your crew and you being a pirate. So you're going to have way more customization when it comes to Skull and Bones than, say, Assassin's Creed, where the biggest focus isn't on customizing anything in that game. If you fear that the learning curve will be too high with Skull and Bones, and you see, like, Siege and For Honor, those two games have a very high learning curve, I think if you play Assassin's Creed, Odyssey, and Black Flag, you won't have to deal with a huge learning curve. I think learning curve will be there if you're a new player to, you know, that kind of, you know, game. But if you played those two games, I feel like you have a good grasp on how Skull and Bones will be able to play. Because, I feel like Skull and Bones will literally play the exact same way as the naval battles in those two games. For me personally, the biggest fear I have with Skull and Bones is balance and whether or not the game works at launch. Because we do not live in a time where we allow games to get better over time. They have to come out perfect nowadays, because we're done with the day one patch shit. We're done with that. We don't care about, you know, this game is worked for the most part, and it'll be better in a few months. No, it has to be perfect the day it comes out. That's where we are right now when it comes to gaming. So, gameplay wise, under the hood, this game needs to launch in a good state, and that's what I fear. I feel like it won't do that. I feel like it will be in a bad state, because Siege was in a bad state when it came out. For Honor launched in a bad state, so I feel like this game would also likely launch in a bad state. That's my biggest fear. Hopefully it doesn't. You know, if the game is laggy, glitchy, buggy, unbalanced, and broken at launch, it will be dead on arrival for the majority of the gaming community. Now, there will be a select number of people who will still stick with the game regardless. Now, that always happens in any kind of video game. You even look at Fallout 76. As much as that game's getting dragged through the mud, it still has a core crowd that keeps playing it regardless. And it's also happened with Ubisoft. You know, Siege, For Honor. Siege had a questionable launch and people turned away from that game quick. But it did have a cult following, which ended up being the catalyst for the rebirth of the game. Got when it came to Pro League, Ranked Play, YouTube. And Ubisoft having been dedicated to not giving up on the game and constantly coming out with patches and updates to improve the game. Now, Siege, because of all the things Ubisoft did to it, and because of the community, you know, sticking with the game, is one of the most popular shooters out there. It's one of the best shooters out there. For Honor had a bad launch as well, and people didn't really return to it, but Ubisoft is sticking with it and pumping in, you know, new content and patches to improve the game. Hopefully, pulling more players into it. I haven't played For Honor forever. So hopefully with Skull and Bones, they give the developers enough time to have a smooth launch with, you know, not too much lag. Lag is going to happen regardless in all the games. No matter how beautifully done the game is in terms of polishing and getting all the bugs, lag is going to happen regardless because of connection lag and, you know, between player and player. So we can't guarantee there won't be any lag, but hopefully there's not a lot of it. Hopefully it's not because of the game itself. There will be a beta, so we'll be able to test out the game and get an experience on what it's like before it comes out. I think it will literally perform just like the Naval Battles in Assassin's Creed. So if you played those games and enjoyed those segments of those games, you'll like Skull and Bones. If you didn't play them, I'd recommend playing Odyssey. It is an amazing game, but it is an RPG. It's not the usual old school action game like Black Flag is. Other Assassin's Creed games are. Now, Black Flag is that old school Assassin's Creed game, so you can pick that up and play Black Flag if you rather do action game with an RPG. But Odyssey itself, amazing game. You know, the gameplay you're seeing is Odyssey, so you're getting a good idea of how naval battles you look at. You can compare, you know, the clips in this video, because at the beginning of this video, it was Skull and Bones gameplay. Then after that, Odyssey gameplay. So you can see how the games compare just watching this video itself. Either way, you will be getting the experience of, you know, what I believe Skull and Bones will be by playing any of those two Assassin's Creed games. But with all that said, guys, that's it for this video. Thank you all for watching. Hope you all enjoyed. Leave any thoughts you have in the comment section below. I'll catch you guys next time. Peace out.